Hi, I'm Tim Belcher, and this weekend I'm going to meet Jimmy DiResta. I want to make him a present. It's a little intimidating. I think I'm going to make him a 3D model of New York and carve it into walnut, put his name and logo on it, and make sort of a New York art piece, because Jimmy is nothing if not New York. I've done this type of thing a couple of times before, carving some lakes in Virginia. I think I have a process down that I can share with you that makes it somewhat repeatable. And I particularly like this project because you can do it on any of the CNCs, including the X-Carve. So stick with me, I'm gonna make a 3D model of New York, a present for Jimmy DiResta. This is how I made it. Hey, before we get to the boring computer stuff, I'm gonna glue up a blank. I'm gonna do it out of this 10-foot-by-5-inch piece of walnut. And I hope to get close to somewhere around 24 inches square. Not sure if I'll be able to do it or not. You've seen me glue up blanks on this channel before, so I'm gonna speed through this one. Now the blank is ready for carving. One best practice I always follow is I ref all home the machine prior to doing these long 3D carves. These carves are gonna take 5 or 6 hours. Once I ref all home, I zero the X and Y and then go find center and then write down those coordinates. If I lose power or the machine resets, which it actually did during this project, I now have a way to find zero again. While we begin this roughing pass, let me move over to the computer and show you how I designed this project. We're first going to start at Google and we're going to look for the USGS EROS state images. And that first link should take you into the United States Geological Survey. And what we're looking for are these USNED state images. And these are fairly high-res, color-shaded relief images of each state. Not quite what we're looking for, but we can use these to get our model created. And this isn't meant to be a step-by-step guide. Depending on the programs you choose, it's going to be different, but I wanted to give you the basics of how I converted this image into a model. And in your photo software, just trim, crop, and get rid of that background color. And I'm doing the full state, but if you wanted to do a lake or some feature, then you would simply find a different cropping point. We're going to turn these images into grayscale, but remember now that they are color shaded relief, not grayscale. So I want to fill in this lower portion and I want to choose a color to do it. So I'm going to zoom in and try and find the highest color representation on this image and use that color to fill in that lower left portion. And I want to do that now before I convert it to grayscale, because this is not a black to white grayscale image. This is a blue to this tan. It's some middle subset of that grayscale, and I want to work in that color palette before I convert it. We're going to be converting this grayscale image into a model, and the colors in that grayscale represent the height of the model. If I were to make that lower left corner white, it would press down the rest of the model. If I were to change the blue to black, it would create too much of a depth change between the land and where we're going to fill with resin. Now that I've got my image, I'm going to pull this into Aspire, where I've got my project set up to the width and height and depth of my blank. I'm going to import that image and size it for the project. And this is one very nice feature of Aspire. I'm going to move over into the modeling section and simply choose to create a 3D model from an image. I realize Aspire can be an expensive software package. There are free ways to do this, and I'll link to a few of those in the description of this video. And once that model is created, I'm going to adjust the height to nearly the full height of the blank. At this point, the model is very rough and jagged. It's representing all of that height information by pixel. So I'm going to apply a smoothing filter to remove that noise and get a much more smooth representation of that topography. And depending on the software you're using and your taste, how much you smooth this model is something you're just going to have to play with. All in, I probably tweaked the image and the model and the Aspire project 5 or 6 times before I got something I was happy with. And to some degree, the hard part's over now. It's traditional CNC. I'm going to create first a roughing pass and then a finish pass. And now you begin to see the final product taking shape. Here I've done the V-carve of the DiResta logo as well as the profile cut. And we're done and ready to mill. Let's get back to the build. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and hit that like button. And if you have any questions, please put them in the comments down below. I'm happy to answer them. And as always, thanks for watching.